months of rumour and speculation all come to an end today as we return to racing for the opening event of what promises to be an enthralling season. Welcome along then to round one of this year's Formula One World Championship. Formula One returns to the desert today on this exceptional 3.36-mile circuit. 15 corners provide plenty of overtaking opportunities, and it could be a strategic race, this one, with Sakhir notorious for eating up the rear tyres. Watch out for drivers managing their rubber at some point during the Grand Prix. It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lightning lines up on pole position, edging out Lando Norris, who'll start from P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Gasly, Albon, Charles Leclerc, and Verstappen, Ricciardo, Latifi, Magnussen, and Yuki Tsunoda, Sainz, Ocon, Richard Vershaw, and Schwartzman, Liam Lawson, Oscar Piastri, Jehan Deruvala, and Yuri Vips, Drugovich, Fittipaldi, Joe, and Valtteri Bottas begins the race from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track. A new season, then a clean slate where anything could happen. Anthony Davidson is with me today as once again we get another year of Formula One underway.
We're into those tense few minutes before the first race then. Everyone's a little bit nervous about reliability. They haven't been running in the hot, turbulent wake of other cars in practice, and they've not been pushing at 100% for long durations. Let's hope no one has to deal with any nasty surprises.
Pole position. Let's go for the win, mate. OK, how was that pull away? You'll have a bit more grip than that on the start, but we need to warm the tyres properly now. Make sure you get some heat into the brakes as well. Okay, good parking there, mate. Now we need to make sure we get a great launch as the race starts. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. Okay, the officials have deployed the safety car due to multiple cars being stopped on track. Mind your delta. Okay, we're coming up to the safety car now. Do not pass it. You are the leader. Follow the safety car. Approaching the safety car, you're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. Are you you okay? That was a nasty hit. Turn the engine off and wait for the marshals. this lap then. Come into the pits at the end of this lap. After these tyres now, we want to finish the race in this compound. Lando in the pits. Behind is 2.8 seconds. gap to your teammate behind is 12.6 seconds.
The performance on the track today, a well-deserved victory. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we've witnessed today.
Here comes your top three making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One. So let's review the driver's standings. Lightning takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. Now, let's discuss Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
Enzo Fittipaldi gets my vote today.
Let's move on to the Constructors. The owner driver's team move to the top of the table. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
Cash in our reserves doesn't help us unless we start investing it back into the team. Let's start thinking about where we can put it to good use.
We need your input here. It's not an easy choice, I know.
Thanks for dealing with that. The department appreciates it.
Thank you.